When we think of viruses, we usually think of parasitic life forms that damage their hosts. However, the polydnavirus is an entirely different story. The polydnavirus is a baculovirus, which is an insect virus. It has formed an intricate relationship with its host, the parasitic wasp, and this parasitic wasp is an insect in the order Hymenoptera. Rather than cause diseases in its host, the polydnavirus actually assists its host reproduction. Consequently, the wasp and the virus exist in an obligatory symbiotic relationship. The polydnavirus is integrated into the wasp's genome, and it is transmitted vertically. This means that it is transmitted from parent to offspring. Interestingly enough, phylogenetic research has shown that the polydnaviruses have been involved with parasitic wasps for over 70 million years. This suggests that the polydnaviruses evolved alongside the parasitic wasps, and that their viral structures and genomes have been largely conserved throughout their evolutionary history. Within the order Hymenoptera, there are over 40,000 species of wasps, and these species can be categorized into two families, Ichneumonidae and Braconidae. Each of these families hosts a different genus of polydnavirus. For instance, Ichneumonidae hosts ichneviruses, while Braconidae hosts bracoviruses. Bracoviruses are cylindrical, while ichneviruses are ellipsoid. This differing morphology is because the two genera of polydnaviruses evolved from different ancestors. However, they both have nucleocapsids and large, circular, segmented, double-strand DNA genomes. They also share similar characteristics, such as integrating into the host's genome, and they both cause similar viral effects. All of this is likely due to convergent evolution. Now, you may be wondering, what is the reason behind this close relationship between the virus and the wasp? The answer lies within the wasp's reproductive strategy. The polydnavirus is integrated into every somatic and germ cell of the parasitic wasp, and it exists as a provirus in the host's nucleus. However, the female wasp has special cells in her ovaries, called calyx cells, where the virus can replicate independently and assemble into an infectious particle. These calyx cells seem to have evolved especially for this purpose. After assembly, the virus exits the calyx cells and gathers in the wasp's reproductive tract near her ovipositor. The ovipositor is a tube-like organ used for laying eggs. In the case of wasps and bees, the ovipositor is the same thing as the stinger. The parasitic wasp requires a host to reproduce. Often, these wasps target garden pests like caterpillars. Once the female wasp finds an unsuspecting victim, the wasp injects her eggs, venom, and a viral load of the polydnavirus particles into the caterpillar. The viral particles do not contain any genetic material, so their only purpose is to express viral genes in the host's host. Since the wasp uses the caterpillar as a living incubator, the caterpillar's body will try to find a way to kill the eggs. However, this is where polydnavirus earns its keep. It suppresses the caterpillar's immune system, which allows for the wasp's eggs to mature and hatch without interference. The polydnavirus genes also affect other caterpillar phenotypes. For instance, the polydnavirus's viral-like particles inhibit metamorphosis, which prevents the caterpillar from entering the next stage of its life. This allows for the wasp's eggs to have a consistent environment for growth. Additionally, the polydnavirus can infect the caterpillar's salivary glands. Here, it limits the secretion of digestive enzymes in the saliva. Typically, the caterpillar's digestive enzymes induce a defensive response from the plant from which the caterpillar feeds upon. This plant immune response consists of defensive enzymes, which tend to stunt caterpillar growth. Thus, by reducing the amount of digestive enzymes in the caterpillar, the polydnavirus is essentially helping the caterpillar evade the plant's defenses, which allows the caterpillar to feed and grow unhindered. Essentially, all of these viral effects help raise the caterpillar as both a living incubator and a food source for the wasp's larvae. Once the larvae are ready to emerge, they burst out of that caterpillar, like that one scene from Alien. At this point, the parasitized caterpillar uses its own silk to build a cocoon for the wasp's larvae, and it aggressively defends the cocoon with its life. It defends the cocoon from predators and other parasitic wasps, which may try to infect the newly hatched wasp larvae. The caterpillar upholds this defense until it starves to death. This odd change in behavior may be due to polydnavirus hijacking the caterpillar's brain and managing to control its actions. Finally, the larvae hatch into wasps, and the cycle continues again.